What if we wanted to use a graph to identify function values? So for instance, let's use the following graph. This is g of x, and find the following. So first, what if we want to find where what g of negative 2 is? Basically, we're looking for the output when the input is negative 2. So we go to our inputs, which are along the horizontal, that's our x-axis, and we go to negative 2, and then we go to the graph. Well, it's right there. So it turns out g of negative 2 is just 0. Okay, what if we want to find g of negative 1? We'll do the same thing. We'll go out to negative 1 on the x-axis, and then go down to the graph. And we get right here. And we see that g of negative 1 is going to be at this point, and its output is negative 4. So, in these two cases, we are given an input and found an output. Now, what if we want to find an input given an output? For instance, find all the values of x that make g of x equal to 0. Well, first thing we have to do is figure out where our outputs are equal to 0. Our outputs are going to be 0 any place on the x-axis. So we actually have three spots where that happens. So the values of x are negative 2, 0, and 3. Now in this case, it's okay that we had more than one answer, because we can have more than one input for the same output. But for each input, for instance negative 2 and negative 1, our output must be unique.